diabetes affects women in a very different way. Both women and men get diabetes, but however, women have a higher risk of heart attack at a younger age if they are diabetic when compared to men of the same age. The risk of diabetes increases about 4 times when compared to a male. Women are also at a risk of higher complications that happen due to diabetes, like kidney disease, depression, and retinal complications. And especially if a pregnant woman is diabetic, then she has the risk of having large babies and a lot of complications during delivery. Diabetes also causes lower survival rates and poorer quality of life after a heart attack if somebody has especially women, for women who have diabetes. Depression is extremely common in women who have diabetes, and again it affects twice more commonly in women than as in men. Women generally don't take care of their health and they always prioritize their family over themselves. So we should be, as women, very conscious and aware of our lifestyle and the diet, and make sure that we take time for ourselves to do exercise. Today I'm going to talk to you about what are the risk factors for women to have diabetes, especially in the Indian setting. So any woman who has polycystic ovarian disease, any woman who has obesity, that is a BMI of more than or equal to 23, any woman who has low physical activity, so hardly exercising, family history of diabetes, and our race, basically Asian race, and if you have delivered a baby who is more than 4 kilos when they were born, all of these are risk factors for having diabetes. Of course, if one has hypertension, one has dyslipidemia, that is elevated cholesterol levels, or history of cardiovascular problems, or something called as pre-diabetes, where you are not there as a diabetic yet, but you are on the borderline. All of these are risk factors for developing diabetes. Today we are going to talk about the effects of menopause on women who are diabetic. Okay, so what actually happens when a woman who is diabetic, she is actually at a risk of a premature menopause. So when somebody has, probably according to their genetic risk, let's say that they probably will have menopause by 55 years of age, women who are diabetic tend to get menopause by 45 or 50 years of age. And because of this premature menopause, they also have an increased risk of cardiovascular diseases. So they are more prone for heart attack. And because of the changes in the hormones, they can also have a lot of fluctuations in their blood sugar level. And they also tend to have a lot of weight gain. And there is an increased risk of needing more insulin and oral diabetic medication. Women also tend to have a lot of depression or anxiety issues during menopause, which can also be attributed or worsened by being diabetic. They also have sleep deprivation, which makes it harder to manage their blood sugar levels. And they also have an increased risk of urinary tract infections, and vaginal infections because their immunity levels are down, especially because they are a diabetic. So women, especially during that premenopausal, perimenopausal age, should be very careful. They should exercise regularly, eat healthy diet, make sure that they are getting enough sleep, and try not to put on weight. Today I am going to talk to you about diabetes and pregnancy. When a woman who is pregnant is diagnosed to have diabetes, it's called gestational diabetes. We do a test called a glucose tolerance test. Basically, we give them a sugar load of about 50 grams of glucose, and then we check the sugars post 1 hour and 2 hours. And based on the numbers, if the numbers are high, then you know we diagnose that woman to have gestational diabetes. The problem when you have gestational diabetes is it's not just a risk for you, it is also a risk for the baby. So what happens when you have gestational diabetes? You can only be treated with insulin. Okay, so you cannot be given oral medications as a general rule. However, there are some exceptions, and a woman who is a diabetic and pregnant needs to be very careful to make sure that they are exercising regularly and eating a low carbohydrate diet. During labor, they have an increased risk of having a cesarean section because the babies are a bit more heavier than normal babies, and they can have complications if they are doing normal vaginal delivery. So women have to be very careful, especially if they have gestational diabetes.